Good evening, everyone, and welcome in to Pokemon Days. So we're going to be carrying on with a bit of Pokemon Diamond. I know it's been a couple of weeks, but let's just dive straight into it, chat. Let's dive straight into it. I hope everyone's having an absolutely fantastic start to their week. Oh God, I'm pressing buttons. I'm pressing buttons and I don't know what they do. Oh! Okay, so that's the town map. I've genuinely got absolutely no idea where we're even supposed to be heading, chat. No idea whatsoever. I can't even remember what we were doing last week, 2 weeks ago. I really should make like a little crib sheet when I finish a stream on Pokemon thing. This is what we're doing, this is where we're going. Ready for next time. We'll heal up to start off with. One of our Pokemon looks like they've got a little bit of health missing, so just to be on the safe side. I feel like we were heading to another town somewhere. We'll have to have a look at the map and have a good look-see around just to work out what, if anything. Right. So, we're in Jubilife. We've got Canalarv. We've got Floramma Town, Eterna, Snowpoint. I've got a funny feeling we're supposed to be heading to Eterna. I'm sure we met, what's his name? Oh, what's the random dude called? Like, is our friend. Not sure. But I think maybe, like, are they grey if we've not visited them? I think maybe. So we'll head over to Canalarv, whatever it's called. Like, I don't think we're supposed to head this way. Yo, Nyx, how you doing? Great, if you haven't been there. Perfect. How are you doing? How's your Monday going? Oh, okay, so we need to swim over that way. Okay, so not that way then, not that way. I can't remember if we've learned how to swim on this one yet. Do we even have a bike? I don't think so. No. Not bad, just playing games with a friend. Nice, what game are you on? Oh, rats. Ooh, a weak looking trainer. You are shit. Oh, hells yeah. I'm gonna bring you down. Weak ass trainer, man. Shh. Sarah, you're gonna regret calling me a weak ass trainer. Oh, you play some Smite? Nice. Bit of fun, Bidoof. Tackle for tackle. Ooh. Well, we got him, chat. Oh, you are kidding me. That's so close. That is so close. Nice! Okay. Told you. You should have said no. You should have called me a weak-ass trainer. Kick your ass. You know, I've never played Smite. I've watched a couple of people stream it before, but it's not one I've ever had a go on, actually. There's a lot of games that like Smite that I've, never even ventured into that sort of style of game. Oh, I can have Magikarps up in a moment. Bidoof. Let's do this, Bidoof. Let's do this. Overall, since season zero, you have like 2,003. Oh my lordy lord. Like, Nyx, where do you find all these hours to play, like, all these games and have several thousand hours in them all? Like, I play games for, like, it's my job and I don't have that many hours in games. Damn. Keep battling, keep battling. Bidoof, you are kicking ass. Alright, so we're going up against the Starly. We'll just go for a standard tackle. Giggity. You're just saying, so do I! So do I! One more tackle and then they are done. Ooh, they got some with a quick attack. Ooh, nice. Bidoof is at level 11 now. Sweet. I'll have to have a look-see see where my, I've completely forgot the name of my Pokemon. What is my Pokemon called? My main one. Turtwig, yeah, he's level 17. Okay, yeah, so we've got Bidoof up to level 7, so we need to have a switch around. Yeah, we want to get Starly up. Get him all over level 10. Oh, actually, before I do this, do we have any Pokeballs? Let's see if we can catch some Pokemon. It's a Bidoof. Right, a bit of cannon fodder here. Quick attack, please. Ooh, pretty good, pretty good. Yeah, shouldn't be much. Right. Another quick attack, and that should be them done. Ooh, 33 XP. That didn't really do much for us, did it, chat? Oh, shit. May I please trouble you for a battle? Well, seeing as you asked so nicely, seeing as you asked so absolutely bloody nicely, I'll say yeah. Last Samantha. A Boodoo, Budgie, Boodoo. I don't think I've seen one of them yet. I don't think. Alright, get a cheeky quick attack in. Okay, yep, that's Sam. We'll do another one of them. Happy days. Ooh. Getting us with a cheeky absorb there, aren't they? Hey, we learned Wing Attack. Nice. Sweet. Okie dokie, okie dokie, okie dokie. Come on, Pokemon, do your thing. There we go, there we go. Alright, it's another Starly. This is Starleon, Starly action. Come on, let's do this. Oh shit, I only did a wing attack. Yeah, let's just see how good it is. Scoodilouche. Right, Starly fainted. 48 XP. Nice, nice. We'll take it. We're almost at level 10 now. Almost at level 10. Happy days. Oh my god. I don't know what it is. Why? Oh no, it's just like, ooh, a Shinx. Do we already, we've already got a Shinx. Okay. Shinx looks cool. We'll just try a wing attack straight off the bat. Ooh, it's not very effective, but it took off like 70% of its health, if not more. Shinx's attack missed. Even better. Cheeky quick attack. Oh, come on. You're so close, man. You are so close. Oh, we got now. What we got now? Another Starly. Okie dokie. Well, we'll just go for the quick attack because we know the normal tackle didn't take him out last time, so there's no point using that. Ooh, so close, chat. So close. Alright, one more quick attack. So you're getting them sneaking one in on us. Only 32 for that one. Ooh, there we go. Level 10. Level 10. Perfect. We can swap over. Alright, Pokemon. So level 10, level 10, level 11. So we've got a Shinx, an Abra, and a Cricketot. Cricketot. You know what, seeing as we'll go get the lowest ones done first. This seems like a good area for leveling up these lower Pokemon, so we'll just do them all up a little bit. Get them all level 10, I think that should be a nice even round for us to start off with. Right, so we've got Growl and Bide. What does that do? I don't know if we're going to be able to bide our time. Takes down to 3 HP. Oh no, that just killed us. Right, okay. Right, Sphinx it is. Not Sphinx, Shinx. Okay, tackle it is. Growl reduces our attack, I think, doesn't it? Yeah. Ooh, it's gonna be a long fight. Gonna be a long fight. Okay, they took off 3 off of us. So we can take another 5-ish of those. Ah, we should be good. We should be good, chat. Nice, Starly's attack miss. That's what we want to see. I wonder why that second hit did way more. No idea. No idea. What on earth happened on that second hit? Come on, Shinx, you can do this. You got this. Come on, come on. Are they? Yes, there we go, right. Keep going. Oh, you cheeky sausage. Gonna auto-load the wrong Pokemon, isn't it? Shit the bed. Okay, never mind. Let's put Shinx back in action. Oof. Okay, we can literally take with our attack missed. We're gonna have to swap Pokemon, so we might as well swap back now. The turds are gone. That's a shame. And he's down, of course he is. Okay, well, at least Shinx is up to level 5. Shinx learned Leer. Okay. Alright, let's put Abra in the prime position. There we go. Like, can I just teleport? Where do we teleport? What does that do? Abra teleporting takes us to the last Pokemon Center we went to. Interesting. Interesting chat. Oh, I never changed Pokemon around again, did I? Oh, so it's a Zubat. Oh, we've already got one. Okay. All right, come on, Abra. Please tell you got more than just teleport. Shit. No. Oh, fuck. Abra needs another move, chat. Abra really needs another move here. Well, I suppose I could technically do up two of my lower Pokemon. So Abra and Shinx. We'll just back to back them. Okay, that's good. We only lost one HP there, so a little bit of a tackle. Happy days. Okay, we probably need three more of them, maybe two if we're lucky. Yo, Ken! How you doing, buddy? Welcome in. Love it, mate. Love it. How the devil are you doing on this fine Monday morning? Morning? What am I on about? Like 9:30 at night. Oh my god. My brain is still mush. Still mush, chat. Oh my god. How you doing, Ken? Hopefully you're good, mate. Hopefully hopefully you're able to talk and doing better than me. Oh, God. Most zombies don't like mushy branch. True, so I'll be fine if there's ever a zombie apocalypse. That is true, mate. So, just being safe, yep, just being safe, mate. Always prepare, that's me. Oh, that did not do as much damage as I was hoping there. So if anyone that's just joined, like Ken, we're just doing some, not farming, kind of farming. I'm just trying to get all my Pokemon above level 10, just in this little patch of grass that we're at now, where all the Pokemon are like pretty low levels that we're going up against, so. Because I did it again, chat. I over-leveled up my starting Pokemon. And, yeah, all the other ones are a little bit on the weak side. Yeah, original one, Turtwig's up to level 17. We've got a couple of others now above level 10, so I'm trying to get all of them just over that level 10 mark. You liked Shinx, but you didn't play it. Like, pretty much all of these Pokemon, mate, unless they're ones that I've had from Pokemon cards, I've never heard of them. Okay, well, we spread all that XP pretty loose. Shit. I quite like Starly, to be honest. And I'm pretty sure all the Pokemon that I'm using, Ken, they're just the first, like, six that I came across. Don't teleport. Okay, why can't I have another move? We probably don't need it, it's only level 4 Starly. Go on, good, add it. So the first time you played, Dom, you were really picky with who you wanted on your team. How were you picky, like, if you didn't know... Yeah, how were you picky then, if you'd not played it before? Oh, excuse me. I'm more of in a anything goes sort of a mood. Based on looks nice. Pokestetics. Love it, mate. Ooh, damn. Starly got a critical hit on me. Fuck. We just need Abra. God, is it finally getting these shitty little levels? Right. So either Sheik just didn't perform or I skipped it somehow. I'm not sure why it wasn't part of my team. Maybe it fell off the level curve. Yeah, mate, that happens a lot. Like, you just... Some Pokemon just don't level up quick enough, and then you end up catching other Pokemon that are just way above them, that you just like, I might as well just use the ones that are already at a higher level. It happens. It does happen, mate. That's what I'm trying not to happen right now. I'm trying to actually utilize all the Pokemon that we've got. At least to a degree. Excuse me. Ooh, damn. Right, we're going for a little cheeky quick attack. Aww, that was a wing attack. Never mind, it'll do the job. It'll do the job. Right, and the enemy Starly is down. 16 XP per fight is just taking the... But you know what? We should just move on. The boulder's blocking the way inside the cavern. I think a Pokemon will be able to break those boulders, though. Actually, you know what we should do first? Heal everyone up, then we'll come back up. So in your most recent playthrough of Diamond, you had all the Pokemon shuffled and played with Nuzlocke rules. What's Nuzlocke rules? And when you say had all the Pokemon shuffled, is that like, do you mean like, is that a randomizer? Yeah, what's Nuzlocke rules? So would you then end up like with really high level Pokemon attacking you early on? Or would you just get Pokemon from different areas early on but as a lower level? No, the level's adjusted. But yeah, so what's Nuzlocke rules? I genuinely don't think that I know any game well enough to play it randomized. Maybe... You know, I don't know. I don't know if I would know if I know any game well enough to play it randomized. Yeah, I know I do. Maybe one of the Metal Gears. Maybe Metal Gear, yeah, Metal Gear 2 or something like that. So basic rules, the Nuzlocke challenge is only two rules that must be followed. Any Pokemon that faints is considered dead and must be released. The players may only catch the first wild Pokemon encountered in each area and none else. If the first wild Pokemon encountered faints or flees, there are no second chances. If the first encounter in the area is a double battle, the player is free to choose which of the two wild Pokemon they would like to catch, but may only catch one of them. Huh. This restriction does not necessarily apply to Pokemon able to be captured during static encounters, nor to shiny Pokemon. Right, okay. What do you mean, like, multiple battle, like, double battles? I don't think I've had a double battle. Oh, a bitch slapped us. Okay. Right, okay. I'm sort of with you. So like when you're walking through the grass, you can get two Pokemon attacking you at once, sort of a jobby. And they're not telling you which game to avoid spoilers. That's fine. Hey, finally, average grease level 7. Sweet. Found an antidote. Sweet. Rock smash. We're going to be breaking lots of rocks, chat. Some of these rocks have items in them. Let's do this. Are you raising different kinds of Pokemon? If you only have the same type of Pokemon, you'll have a hard time against types it's weak to. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. Let's have a battle while smelling the aroma of flowers. Weird. Weird way to introduce yourself there. Right, aroma, oh, okay. It's in her wheelhouse. Right, Abra. Man, Pokemon music is banging today! So there are more rules, but the two base rules are Pokemon that faint die, only allowed to catch the first encounter per route and area. Nice. But what if you... like... what if you don't catch a Pokemon in any area? Just giving nicknames form stronger bonds. Huh, didn't know that. It annoys the crap out of me giving them nicknames. And I've never had an issue where a Pokemon hasn't, like, done what I've asked it to. You know, I think I did in, like, the early games when I first played them through. Stronger bonds between you and your Pokemon. This is not in-game. Right, okay. This is player Pokemon stuff. Okay, I'm with you, Ken. I'm with you. Libby found an awakening. Nice. Find us some Pokemon, chat. Oh, it's a Zubat. It's a Zubat. Go, Abra, and don't attack because you've got no attacks because you're useless right now. If you'd name your Abra... let's say Greg. I wonder where this is going, Ken. Okay. Just seems a bit of a specific name for you to pick there, Greg. Come on, Abra. You can have him. Oh, sorry, chap. Excuse me. It's been another long, 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 long day. Hadoof is down. Ken, I really like the Nuzlocke plus randomizer combo. It so increases replay value since most Pokemon games have the same formula and it can feel stale. Yeah, I get that. It adds like an extra, an added challenge to it. The challenge I have is just trying to find where I've got to freaking go in these games. So listen, what's your opinion on bug Pokemon? Don't really have one. Yeah. Oh, another important role. Yes, Ken. Which is not universal, but you like it a lot. Yeah, go for it. The next gym leader's highest level Pokemon is your level cap until you beat them. Yeah, but Ken, that's that. If you keep going up against them and failing, your level will keep going up. Like, don't get me wrong. If you got to the stage where your level was, well, you can't stop yourself leveling up. You know what I mean? The odds of that happening would be very slim to none, but it does. Of course it does. Any XP you get, they do. they do, mate. Any XP you get during a fight doesn't erase when you die. Only the last fight. Like, say if you're going up against a gym leader who's got 5 Pokemon. Well, you'll gain XP for the first 4 Pokemon if you then die at the 5th Pokemon every time. Again, a Pokemon fainting. Oh, shit me, Ken. Fucking hell, okay. Okay. With, yeah, okay, yeah, sorry, mate. Sorry, yeah, you are right, I forgot about that. I'm not used to these, Yippee-ki-yay rules, or whatever we're calling them. Oh, Wurmple. Starly is level 12. Let's go. Bug catcher Brandon. Screw you, buddy. Screw you. Oh, twins. Hey, we can one-shot this trainer, can't we, Liz? Liz, you're the strongest in our class. Oh! Ho ho ho! Well, you haven't been to the School of Lib yet, have you? Liv and Liz, let's go. Pachirusu and a Pachirusu. Oh. Okay, they're very bouncy Pokemon. So there we go, Abra and Turtwig. Okay, well, Abra, you can't do jack shit, mate, so let's switch you out for. Sure. No. Starling. Oof. Oh, damn. They're picking on Starling. Fucking hell. Go on, Turtwig. Fucking have him. Have him. Oh, did we attack both of them then? No. It didn't KO them? What? Oh, but it did attack both of them. So what? I get like some moves like Surf affect both players, but I wonder why Razor Leaf affected both of them. Is there some rule on that, Ken? Like why a move would attack both players as opposed to just the one that you aimed at? Right, okay. Right, let's heal these bad boys up. Not every fire move has the same chance to ignite. Not every move hits just one target. I wanted to get some flowers from Floroma Meadow, but some Team Galactic guys in snazzy outfits came along. Those Galactic guys went to the meadow past these flowers here. Oh my god. There's an Oran berry, pick it! Yep! Oh my god, we can do some berry picking again. Yeah, we'll plant a berry. Oh, we only picked one berry off of it. Oh, is the game not being really nice and giving us a load of berries? Oh man, can you no longer like savagely farm berries? A single berry will grow into a plant that makes several. Okay, well that answers that one then, chat. Obtain the Asper berry. Trainer, please water berries using the sprayed up watering can. Skadoosh. Would you like to exchange your berries for accessories? I don't know what any of these things do. I'm not gonna lie to you. I thought you were trying to con me for berries. Alright, plant some berries. Oh yeah, I've already spoke to you. It's fine. It's fine. Floroma Town was a barren, desolate hill long ago. People started planting flowers on it because it was such a sad place, but nothing would grow. People didn't know what to do. And then one day, someone expressed thanks to the blessing of nature. Then the whole hill burst into bloom. Isn't that strange and wonderful? Pretty much so, yeah. Do you think it's cute how Pokemon pluck berries? Sure. Yes, you agreed. Here's the TM for the new move, Pluck. Sweet, chat. Sweet. Just agree with people, they give you shit. Nice. Thank you. I got drawn here by the sweet scent of honey. Seriously, what's that? What am I? A Pokemon or something? Honey. Okie dokie. I simply love it here. The atmosphere is so uplifting. You came to get emotionally healed too, didn't you? Probably not. But one, aren't we Team Galactic and we're assigned here, standing around among flowers? This doesn't seem all that cool. Or two, hey now, don't complain. This is a pretty decent assignment. But bug and grass type Pokemon so creep me out. I don't like being here either. Okay, they're just repeating themselves. Okay, I get it, You don't like bugs. You do not like buggios. What's in there? What's in there? Nothing in there. Some kinds of Pokemon appear only if they're attracted by the sweet scent of honey. Pokemon must have an acute sense of smell. They can sense the aroma of honey from very far away. Okay, so Pokemon like honey, apparently, chat. Like, is this... Are these, like, new grasses, these flowers? Do Pokemon appear in the flowers? I'm guessing not. Pretty sure it would happen by now if that was going to happen. Okay. So let's just have a quick gander on the map, see where we're at. So, okay, we've been there, Floroma Town. We're now heading potentially to Eterna City. Ooh, free berries. And we're still only getting one berry from each of these bushes. That's no good at all. I didn't know I could move. Help, help. Please can you get my papa for me? He works at the Valley Windworks, but the people dressed like spacemen, I mean, he won't let me in. Pretty random, but... We, Team Galactic, are conducting research at the Eterna Forest. This is as far as you will go. Our research involves catching Pokemon in the flowery meadows of Floroma Town. We're also using the energy of the Valley Windwork for something, but that is no concern of you. Run! Ah, bastards. Okay, I get it. Alright. Ooh, we got some wind farms. Okay, we need this. Pachirisu. Alright, Shinx, it's your time to shine. We don't want to kill it. We want to catch it. Pokemon! Oh, it's biding on us. It's biding on... Oh, shit, it might kill us, actually. We're only level 5. Okay, keep storing energy. That's fine. Just don't kill us. I saw that, Jay. Mate.
Give me.
Oh. Mate, literally just looked at chat as your thing popped up. Mwah! 10 free biddies for Lib. Oh yeah. How you doing, buddy? You and your stupid intuition. Oh yes. I felt a disturbance in the force. What a week's worth of playing Star Wars games I'll get you, mate. Oh shit, we're dead, aren't we? Ooh. Okay, we're gonna have to change it. You're not gonna survive long. Ken, if you keep doing Pokemon days, you might want to try some randomized Nuzlocke goodness. Oh dear God, Ken. Hell no, mate, hell no. We've still got a lot of Pokemon games to get through, mate, before we even reach the current gen. And then we've still got the other 2/3 of the generations that we haven't done yet. We got lots of Pokemon to keep us going. And there's other Pokemon games as well, not just these sorts. We've got online Pokemon TCG. We've also got Pokemon Stadium, which I've got, and I'm ready and raring to go on that one. Okay, we're both storing energy. We're both biding. But yeah, I'm doing good, Joe. I'm doing good, mate. We've been doing a bit of leveling up today to try and get our Pokemon a bit more balanced, because my main Pokemon Turtwig was level 17, and I've managed to get two of them past level 10. The rest of them are lurking just a little bit below. But we've got an Abra that can only teleport, so it's just a bit of a... Like, are we actually doing any damage to that thing? Yeah, so it's taking its time. We've moved on a little bit now. I just wanted to make sure that we didn't go past an area that we were able to farm in. Like, what are my two Pokemon doing? Right, so they're both biding and doing absolutely bagger all. Essentially. You watch Pachirisu now just do a quick attack. How's your Monday gone, Jay? You having a good start to the week, buddy? Okay, that's as far as I need to go. Let's have a little rummage in my ball sack. Oh, you little fucker, really? Like, really? Of course it did. You just woke up. Like... Like, just woke up for the day, or just woke up because you had an afternoon, evening nap? I'm hoping it's the latter. Because, mate, if you've just woke up, you had a nap, that's alright. I'm going to say, if you just woke up, that'd be some serious body clock altering goodness. Yo, Sin Life, good morning, gamers. How are you doing, mate? How are you doing on this fine Poke Monday? We just caught the level 7 Pachirisu, guys. It's an electric squirrel. And Ken, so your Shinx would have a nickname, let's call it Jay, and you'd be really scared that if the squirrel attacks Jay, could die. I think you're really overestimating mine and Jay's connection here, Ken. So not longer myself took up. I thought, what the fuck is it with everyone having a nap? I haven't had a nap. I could have done with a nap, but I've been looking after a 2-year-old all day. I could definitely have done with a nap. Jeez. God. Today's international... Oh, is it really? Oh, man, I wish I'd known that. Don't you dare go into the Valley Windworks. I got ordered to keep everyone out if they're not part of Team Galactic. You're giving me a look that makes me think you're going to try to get in. Okay, you'll have to battle me for it. I'm up for that. Jay, I don't die, Ken. I just wind it out. That's the problem. Yeah. Looking after a 2-year-old isn't automatic. It should be. Why do you get a nap, Jay? Come on. And Sin, what? Why do you both deserve a nap over me, who's been up since like some stupid o'clock this morning? Like, I've had a serious lack of sleep. You've got 6 children, Jay. How did I not know? What? Okay. Jay wins the competition of who deserves more sleep. I'm gonna shut up. Well, either Jay is or the milkman is Sin. Holy moly. What's a Glammeow? Oof. Jay is the milkman. Ah, makes sense now. Makes sense. Yo, Dusty. Oh, I didn't do it. I haven't had a chance today, Dusty. Sorry, it's been a bit of a manic day. Been trying to sort shit out. Sorry, dude. Sorry. What the fuck? How can you do me like this? Dusty, genuinely, I'm so sorry. I will get it sorted. I've been on daddy daycare today and been trying to sort out some of the stuff going on. So yeah, apologies. I've not managed to get it done, but I will 100% get it done for you at some point in the not too distant future. That is a guarantee. That is a lib certified guarantee that it will happen at a nondescript date in the future. 100%, 100%, 120% guarantee there. Yo, Primal, welcome in. How are you doing? How is everyone doing? We've had a few people just jump in there. Hope everyone's having a good evening tonight. Yeah, we got Abra up to level 10. When will Abra learn another move, chat? That is the question. So, Ken, I just checked the list of international days and nap day is not a thing. Ooh, who lied to me? Who said it was international nap day? Of course it was Sin. Of course it was Sin. Running after him? No. Primal internet issues? Oh, not again, dude. Fuck. Sin, listen. Every day is international nap day. Try and stop me. He's got a point. He's fucking got a good point, Ken. Yeah, Primal internet issues, mate. Virgin. Like, I used to be with Virgin. Well, I technically still am. But I used to be with Virgin at my old house. And honest to God, I had so many issues with them, with the broadband just randomly disconnecting and stuff like that. Like, and I dealt with this for years and years and years. And I mean years and years and years and years. Too long. For somebody like me that's like me that gets quite irate about these things, far too long. Far too long I dealt with this bullshit for. Went over to Sky, never had a single issue with them. Never had a single issue. The only reason why I'm not with Sky for the internet at my current place is because Sky can't provide me with the fast enough internet here. Whereas Virgin do. Touch wood, the internet, other than the Wi-Fi dropping out all the fucking time. Touch wood, the internet's been pretty decent here. But as soon as Sky gets their ass into gear and gets my area covered with the super fast fibre, I'll be switching straight off the bat. Problem also, download speed is a solid 500 megabytes. Upload is somewhere between 6 megabytes and a lovely 0.5. Ah. That's unfortunate. Oh, shit. Have they given any indication if they're going to get an engineer out or something? Tomorrow is International Day of Argania. What's Argania? Argania? And the list of international days is actually really interesting. Jay, I need a new hub to upgrade to the faster speed, though. Won't they just upgrade you for free? Or let me guess, because you're a current customer, they don't give a shit. It's the way these things normally go. And I'm not just saying that about Virgin. They're all blue like it. The Argan tree, Argania spinosa, is a native species of the sub-Saharan region of Morocco, in the southwest of the country, which grows in an arid and semi-arid areas. It's the defining species of a woodland ecosystem, also known as Arganeri, which is rich in endemic flora. It is reliant to a harsh environment under water scarcity, rich in erosion and poor soils. Oh, okay, sure. Problem, they didn't even know it's an issue. They think I'll wait 24 hours. Oh dear. Jared, I don't know. Everything says something different when you go to a different... But yeah. Boozle. Hey, look at me. I'm Boozle. Sorry, he's level 8. We'll go over to Bidoof. Background, this unique region where almond trees have been cultivated for centuries combined with biodiversity. It's available for a reason. Oh, okay, so it's like a, Oh, Jay, it's that's the international day for today. Sim was saying today was International Map Day. Today is the international day for that tree. Well, those trees. Oh, all right. Tomorrow. My bad. Oh, dear. I was on your side as well. I was on your side, Ken. Fuck the tree. Chop it down. Fuck it. Right. I've clicked out the game, haven't I? There we go. Let's get this Boozle. Oh man, he just spat on me, the cheeky little bastard. Right. Come on, Boozle. How'd you like my tackle? Hey-o! Fuck the trees. We don't need them. I'm joking, I like trees. If you didn't have trees, you wouldn't have to have tree houses. You know, the by far top tier level of, you know, living outside the treehouse. Come on. We'll go for one more. Probably end up killing it. I'm doing it. There's no international day on your birthday yet, so you still have things to achieve and proclaim. Mate, do it. You wanker. I didn't want to get XP. This is the one time I wasn't trying to get XP. Fuck. I was trying to catch me some Pokemon. Well, we've already got one of you, you little hoppy bastard. Whoa. Right. Come on, Turtwig, let's get in there. Let's slap him around a bit. And let's piss off. Let's go. We can do this. Store energy all you want. I'm going to bury you in rocks. Oh. Apparently, that wasn't such a life-ending move that I thought it was going to be. A bit of razor leaf there. Well, prime up, mate. I hope I get it sorted for you, because yeah, I hate internet issues. It's just such a pain. Like, the annoying thing is, it's just a cable that sends a signal and receives a signal. Like, how do they fuck it up? You know what I mean? It's really not that difficult. And yeah, I know there's other factors, chat. But it's funny how, you know, sometimes you can make a complaint about something not working and they're like, oh, there's nothing wrong on our end. And then you can guarantee within a couple of hours of being on the phone to them, it'll start working. Ooh, a Shellos. Oh, no. The only thing that I can recommend is to do like a full power cycle reset on it. So like you unplug it for... Well, either you unplug it for... Is it like 8 minutes or something and then plug it back in? Or in the back of your router, does it have one of those little holes that you put a paperclip into to push the button? Try that. Like, try the full bloody reset jobby on it. Yeah, it's just random as. What are we doing? I'm gonna catch a Pokemon, right. It's been rebooted and you've pushed the reset. I'm all out, mate. I'm all out of ideas. And I technically used to be a telecommunications engineer as well back in the day, so. Yeah, no problem. I appreciate the lurk, man. I appreciate it. I hope you get it sorted, dude. I'd rather you be stream. This sounds bad, but I'd rather your internet work and you be able to stream than you having to lurk. Ken said, I tried to listen to y'all's internet issues, but I found out that 2105 is International Tea Day. As in 21st of May? Every day. See, I'm with Sin on this one. Every day is International Tea Day. Every day. Yeah, quick attack should be less damaging. But it's got increased speed but less power. Okay, I'm gonna have to try and catch this bad boy now. Damn, that did a lot of damage. Right, let's go. Hey, we got the Shellos guys. Nice. It's a sea slug Pokemon. Its colors and shapes differ from region to region. In the Sinnoh region, two types are confirmed. Nice. So chat, as we've got a few people in tonight, go on then. Just because I'm intrigued, we'll set up a little poll. What do you prefer? And this is gonna be divisive. What's better, chat? What's better? Tea or coffee? Ooh, tea or coffee. I know what's getting my vote. Tea. Yeah, Nick's like, I love the smell of coffee, but I fucking cannot stand the taste of it. I genuinely hate it. It's just horrid. And I wish I liked to drink it because there's so many nice coffee drinks out there, or ones that look like they could be nice if I'd enjoyed the taste of it. Whereas tea. There's standard tea. And don't get me wrong, there's all like fancy fruit teas and Earl Greys and things like that. But for one, Earl Greys and anything like that, any floral teas are just nah. I don't want to drink rose petals, thank you very much. Not for me. Fruity teas I like to a degree, but they always smell better than they taste. Or they smell stronger than they taste. If fruity tea tasted like it smelt, I'd be all over that. Primal, I prefer tea, but sometimes I need coffee. See, that's the thing. I need coffee, but can't drink coffee because I hate coffee. Like, every form of everything about it, in any, you know, whether it be coffee-flavoured chocolate or, like, syrups for ice cream or ice creams or puddings or just anything, I can't stand it. Ken, I don't drink coffee. The smell is nice, though. Yeah, I only drink tea to treat myself when I'm ill. As a little placebo. I've never heard about people having a cup of tea when they're feeling poorly. See, if I'm feeling poorly, then I think like a hot chocolate would be a nice little pick-me-up. Hot chocolate or, you know, cup of soup. Next, you don't need coffee, just caffeine. Well, I used to drink blackcurrant fruity teas with about 4 sugars in. Figured out eventually Robina is cheaper. That's true, mate, that's true. Like, the blackcurrant fruity teas or the pomegranate ones or... To be fair, just any of the fruity teas, they smell amazing. But they just taste like watered down shit. They really do. It genuinely would just be easier just to boil some water and put it in a Ribena. And I've never been a fan of like green tea. I've tried it, I don't get it. I don't understand it. And like things like honey and lemon tea, they're okay. Peppermint tea, it does settle your stomach. Peppermint tea is very good for a poorly stomach. But like ginger and honey teas for when you got a cold or something, they work well, but they taste rank. And I love ginger. Really, really do. Yeah, how's the poll looking? How are we looking? Oh, everyone's voted tea so far. Interesting. Can I be cheeky and chuck another vote in? Oh no, I've already done it. Primal, hot Ribena Vimto when you have a cold is amazing. See now, Primal, I'm a big fan of the black sips, so the blackcurrant lem sips, black sips. That's what I call them. They're just called blackcurrant lem sips, but I call them black sips. I think they're amazing. And I like lem sips as well. A couple of sugars in a lem sip though, they're a bit too bitter. Yeah, green tea's just, I don't see the point in it. I don't. I'll be honest with you, I've never tried adding milk to it. I think that'd be weird. Primal, screw the teas for illness, just honey and lemon is fine with some boiling water. Yeah, yeah, totally. Totally. Ken, so drinking tea to treat yourself is a thing here in Germany. My mother always made fennel tea if we had a stomach ache. So I keep using fennel tea when I felt ill, although I understand it's just a placebo when probably no real health benefits. Well, there very probably are health benefits from it. Like, it depends what type of ill, whether you just mean if you've got a cold or if you've got a stomachache. Like, fennel is very aniseedy, isn't it? So that could help, you know, it's quite fragrant. So that could very much help, like, open airways, as it's got that, not mentholiness about it, but it's definitely got that hum. Fennel's definitely got a hum about it. Hey, T1 guys, hell yes. Yes, you are all welcome. And yeah, any form of warm liquid in the stomach will help a stomach ache. Because a lot of times a stomach ache's down to an imbalance in your pH levels. So adding any form of like water or like, you know, pretty much a 7 pH liquid. So like a tea or something like fennel would just help balance the stomach ache. So I think it's probably right. Yeah. Primal, blackcurrant is pure nostalgia for English people, I think. I don't know about nostalgia. I don't ever particularly remember having like much blackcurrant as a kid. Like, if I had to think of like squash as a kid, it would be orange. Right, where are we going? Where are we going? Okay, they still won't let me in. Oh, you know what? Yeah, Primal, to be honest. Sorry, Vimto. A can of Vimto. Oh. If me and the missus, we ever have, like, chip shop, got to have a can of Vimto. Got to be done. Yeah, like, a can of Vimto does actually have nostalgia for, like, if we'd ever go to the pub as a kid, like, with my parents, having a can of Vimto. Yeah. Or a can of Orange Tango. They're the two. But then also, when I was a kid, you know, Iron Brew, Dandelion and Burdock. Oh, Dandelion and Burdock. Does anybody else have Dandelion and Burdock? It's one of those drinks that I drink it and I'm like, I really like this, but at the same time, I really don't like this. It's a weird one. Ken, I found a site of a big tea company here to actually check for claims, but they are very careful when it comes to their lingo, making no claims about any benefits, just reporting common uses and beliefs by people. Yeah. Well, Ken, they've got to. They can't claim that it does something if it hasn't been scientifically proven to. Just in case somebody sues them. Only people in what do you call the industry for pharmaceuticals? Only they would. But yeah, Dandelion and Burdock. I need to get a can of Dandelion and Burdock and see how it is. I might have to do like a tier list of nostalgic drinks. What do you reckon, chat? Would that be a bit of content you'd like to see? Lib does soft drinks. Tier list. We get all the classics. And oddly, I always loved Cherry Tango. But I hate any other form of like flavoured cherry thing. And I, like, all my mates really think I'm weird for this, but I associate Cherry Coke, for example, the same with this as the same flavour as Dr. Pepper. And they're like, no, Dr. Pepper isn't cherry. And I'm like, but to me, it tastes like it, but they're like, no, it's like, but Dr. Pepper's more marzipan. I'm like, yeah, well, I don't like marzipan either. And I kind of associate those flavours together. Like, what do you call, is it like a cherry Bakewell that's got marzipan and cherry in it? And those two things together is just like a nightmare for me. Genuinely. Just, bleh. I'll give these guys another water. Oh, like, I can't stand Dr. Pepper. Like, if somebody has an amaretto and Coke, that tastes like Dr. Pepper to me. See, another thing is, I love real fresh cherries, no problem, but you give me those, like, fake glacier cherries in a cake or something and just... No thanks. They just taste horrible. But yeah, fresh cherry. Love it. Bloop. Do. Oh, I've just thought of another one. Tizer. Oh my god, do they still make Tizer? Upload speed hit a new low of 0.1. Oh my god. Like, dude, are you sure nobody else is using your internet in your house? Probably you haven't seen Tizer since you were 3. Oh, that does not bode well for me trying to get a can of this then, does it? I don't want enough arguing. Hand over the sweet honey. One, two. Do as we say. Team Galactic will have that honey. We must have it to attract Pokemon in great numbers. Oh. Come on. Hey, this kid is a witness. What do? We don't need that brat running off to get help. The solution's simple. We ensure the brat stays quiet. Okay. It's on, chat. It is on. So is this a double fight are we doing? No. I'm not 100%. I checked on the dashboard. Everyone else is in bed, and I know what all the devices connected are. And can you see, like, the download and upload rates for each of those devices? Like, the only reason why I asked that dude is, like, for example, like, if people have got, like, my Xbox One it's set so that it does any updates like overnight or when it's turned off and things like in the, it just does it in the background. So if you've got any devices plugged in, they could be doing updates. Or like, again, for example, your TiVo, if you've got TiVo with Virgin, if that's recording something or downloading, you know, the next episode of something in the background, that again can be utilizing a lot of your, that shouldn't actually be affecting your upload speed though. Neither of those things should affect your upload. But yes, just see if any of your other devices are hogging it. It's worth a look if you've got the data. Because sometimes you do have devices that just conflict. Because one thing that they'll tell you to check as well, if you do get into it, is they will literally tell you to turn off every single device in your house that uses or has the potential to use your internet, and then reset your router and do all that. And then you slowly turn them back on one at a time and see if you still have issues. Grunt number one. What am I saying? Number one. I was gonna say numero uno, and I went with number one. He's down. This is so lame. They're gonna dock my pay. I'm up next, Batman. You're right after my cohort. Weekend, you give me the mate. I wouldn't say weekend, mate. Problem. I can see a speed, but it must be download speed, and the numbers are seemingly random. Right, Primal. The only other last thing I can suggest, mate. Right. So you know the white cable that goes into the back of your router from your wall, right? I've had so many issues with those in the past, especially when I was with Virgin as well. Have you done a full, completely unwind it from both ends, from the wall and from your hub, while your hub's off, screw them back in, make sure you're getting a really nice firm connection on them. Again, it shouldn't make a difference. But sometimes those cables, I do find they, if they flex a bit, they can sometimes not be as good. Shouldn't happen, but it does. You back down. Thank you. You can have another look. The full capacity download is what's messing with me. How do you mean, mate? Hey, level 18 Turtwig, nice! Nice, 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 nice. What we got? Ooh. Turtwig evolved into a Grodle. Oh, you know what that means? We need to add a new Pokemon. Sorry chat, I'm just adding the new picture to the Pokemon list. Download speed being unaffected mostly while upload is non-existent. Anyway, enjoy your Pokemon. Virgin will take the earful tomorrow. Mate, no, I appreciate it, dude. I appreciate it. Hopefully you get it sorted out. As I say, definitely try the thing with disconnecting all devices from the internet. Every single one of them, including your television box, and then try them all one at a time, starting with your TV, and seeing how you get on from that, mate, because that hopefully might solve the problem. But yeah, dude, you have a cracking night, dude. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out, even with the bad internet. I really appreciate it, buddy. And yeah, you take care, mate. You take care. Right, have we got a new Pokemon showing up on the thing? One second. Okay, it should be showing up next. Boom, we got ourselves a Grodle, guys. Oh, what's this thing? They seem to have forgotten it. It's a works key. It must be for the Valley Windworks. It's of no use to me. You may as well have it. These goons were going to rob me of my sweet, sweet honey. They sure were weird, though. You saw how they were dressed? All they saying didn't make a whole lot of sense either. Oh, I need to thank you. Will you take this as my thanks? Ooh, free honey. Have a card for the honey. Right, if you slam that honey on a sweet-smelling tree, it might attract Pokemon. Okay. And if that's a euphemism, it wants me to put honey on my trunk. If you put honey on a tree, check back later to see if it's rustling. If it is, it's quite often a rare Pokemon. Ooh, it gets my hopes up if I see that happening. The flowers that grow in the fields here are special. Did you see how they're more vivid than flowers elsewhere in Sinnoh? You can thank Pokemon for that. Alright, so just like any tree I can put honey on. Like this one. Okay, we'll put honey on that tree. Right, we're gonna go. Wait. Ah, yeah, it's up here. I remember, chat. It's fine. I remember. And those berries don't grow very quick, do they? How much honey do we have? Just had the one batch, unfortunately. Alright, let's go. What? No way, you have the key? Locking the door was meaningless. I am the loser in this after all. This is no time for self-pity. I've got to alert the commander. Alright, let's rock and roll. I ain't fooling around, kid. This is how a professional does it. Ooh, let's take him down, chat. Let's take him down. Sorry, I'm really getting into the Pokemon. Has my new Pokemon appeared on the screen yet? I don't think it has. This almost feels like it should be Doom music. Razor Leaf. Oh, it avoided the attack. Interesting chat, interesting. Let's try Razor Leaf again. Okay, we got it, we got it, we got it. Skadoosh, nice. Collecting electricity from the Valley Windworks? That's our mission. Oh. They just gave away their evil plan. What are they playing at, chat? What are they playing at? Well, you're challenged by Galactic Grunt. Galactic Grunt sent out Wurmple. Every time I do that. Come on, why isn't Abra learning any other moves? Although, think about it, I need to swap Abra out. Because he's level 12 and he doesn't do shit. Whereas other Pokemon that do shit, I still like level 3. And this sort of an area where there's lots of battles, we need to take advantage of that. Come on, come on. Oh, why didn't I just tap out? What happened there? Right, so we've used Razor Leaf against this Glammeow. Skadoosh. Nice, chat. Nice. Let's go. Pokemon, switch them out, switch them out. Right, that level 3 should go up pretty quickly. My Pokemon can't battle anymore. They're going to take away my Pokemon from messing this one up. Just you wait, our commander will smoosh you. Why did I say smoosh? Smush. I'm one of Team Galactus' 3 commanders. We've been trying to create a new world that's better than this one. People have shown little understanding about what we do. You don't understand either, do you? It's a little saddening. So let's have a battle to decide what we should do next. If I win, you leave. Okay, okay. It's like that, it's like that. Why? Oh, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? Oh shit, yeah, not fight with that Pokemon, that's for certain. Right, Groddle, you're up. The foe Zubat used, what? go for a Razor Leaf. Come on. Take him down. Take him out. Oh, not a Toxic. Shirt balls. Genuinely don't know if I've got anything to get rid of that. Well, that was... excuse me, chat. That was not effective at all, was it? What do you think you're doing to my Pokemon? I mean, what do I think I'm doing to a Pokemon? I'm attacking it. Like, what? It's not very effective, is it? No. Shit the bed. Have we got anything for curing a poison or... Yes! Nice! Happy days, chat, happy days! Oh, it's leeching us. So we need like 49 HP right now. So potion, no, yeah, one of them. There we are. We are back in the game. Come on. I'll go Razor Leaf again then. Oh man. Toxic dust. We got Toxic again. Poisoned. We got poisoned. That's the fucking adjective. Well, we'll just do another Razor Leaf. Get it out of the way. Oh, I'm sorry, chat. Oh, dear. Ooh, so close. So close. All right, come on. We got this. Okay, that's one fight done. Brickadot just grew to level 4, is that all? That level 5 as well. Nice. Okay, we'll take that. Yeah, we're hurt by poison. It's fine. Commander Mars is about to send in Purugly? Yeah, let's switch again. Do the old bait and switch. Ah, so this is the evolved state of Glammeow. Well, let's see what our Razor Leaf does. We used a faint attack. Hit the bed. Okay, we need to use a potion. Was that? Well, it had an Iron Berry. No. Shit. Okay, that did not heal me as much as I needed it to. Oh man! Okay, we might not survive this. It's all good. It's all gravy. It's all gravy, chat. Yeah. Okay, let's use Starly, see what we can do. Yo! Megan, how you doing? Welcome in, welcome in. Hope you're having a cracker day. Appreciate the lurk. Thank you for stopping by. Hope you're having a good Monday. Oh, damn, that hurt. That hurt. Come on. Right, can we get a quick attack in at least? Doof, I think it's up to you. Yo, thank you for the hydrate. Appreciate it. Cheers, cheers. Oh god, you gone for the trifecta, haven't you? Stretching a posture. Kirkpatrick from the shadows. Oh, appreciate it, thank you, thank you. Always welcome, always welcome from the shadows. Come on, we've got to take out this kitty cat. Oh my god. Come on, can we get in another tackle before they... No, we can't. Shit the bed. I mean, like, it's got so little health left. Come on. Can we just get the first attack in one of these times? I don't think we're going to be able to, are we? Fuck. I don't even know if that does anything. But Abra can only do the one sodding move and it doesn't do anything. Like, all we can do is teleport. Yo, Jay, I didn't even hear the mystery sound, dude. We're dead anyway. We're dead anyway. God damn it, chat. Wait, what? We lose money because we lost? Oh, damn. So I don't hear it. Why are we not getting the sound coming through? Are any of the others working? Wait, didn't this happen last week? Right, so none of the sound alerts are working. What did we do last week that fixed this, chat? Wasn't it because I'd done something stupid? Can anyone remember? Everything looks like it's a-okay. Wise. Okay, now they're working. There you go, Jay. No idea why it wasn't working. I've refreshed the browser source for it. Right. All there, happy and healthy. Good luck and take care. Right, let's go win this bloody fight, chat. We were robbed then. We were like so close to winning. Just gotta remember which freaking way I was going now. Was it this way? Oh. So it was this way. We go. See you then, losers. Right, Pokemon, which way? Which way? Sure. Let's go. Sorry. I'm excited. I want to win this fight. I want to win it, chat. I want to win it. All right, Mars, you're going down. Yo, Necro. How the devil are you doing today? Hey up, hey up, hey up. How's your Monday? Hope you're alright. I'm doing alright, thanks. It's been a long day of daddy daycare. I'm doing alright. Had a slight issue with but Necro never apologise for being away. It's no problem at all, Hopefully hopefully everything's going well on your end, so hopefully the crazy 8 or 9 days are now calm and peaceful, and you're okay. Yeah, as I say to everybody, I please never feel like you need to apologise for not being here. Obviously, it's a shame you're not here, because I love chatting with you, but at the same time, don't ever feel like you need to be. A bit calmer, not bad, just crazy. Gotcha. Yeah, I had a potential little issue today where the mother-in-law, who normally looks after my little lad on a Tuesday and Wednesday, she's now got a stomach bug, so she's not able to look after him, and very uncertain as to whether I'll be able to get any childcare to cover. And with this being a 3-day week only for me, because I'm not working Friday, because again, looking after the little one, it was looking like we were just going to have just Thursday stream. Obviously, we want to start DS3 this week, and luckily, I've managed to sort out childcare for tomorrow. Wednesday's still up in the air at the moment, so there's going to be a stream tomorrow. I think it's going to be DS3. Like, worst case scenario, potentially, we'd have DS3 tomorrow, then have no stream Wednesday, then have DS3 again Thursday, no stream Friday, and then we'd have to wait again until the following Tuesday to get back on it. So I'm not sure whether you guys would all be all right with it being that broken up, or whether I should just leave DS3 for a week again. Like, the thing is, I really want to get into it, and I know you guys really want to watch it as well. So I'm kind of, I don't know which way to swing with it, whether we should just do it for the days that we've got available this week, or just, I don't know, put the nail on the head. Yo, Jay, now, what Pokemon do you want, mate? Any particular Pikachu? Just standard, bog standard Pikachu. Pikachu in a cap. Gigantamax Pikachu. Partner Pikachu. Cosplay Pikachu. Cosplay Pikachu? Just standard Pikachu. God, there's so many Pikachus. It's ridiculous. I'll go start a Pikachu for now. There we go. Let me try this one. This might not work. But it should work. Oh, he's massive. He's fucking massive. How was Star Wars Week called Bits and Bobs? Yeah, no, it was good. It was good, thanks. It was really, really awesome just to be able to play some cool old school games that I've not played in absolutely yonks. I just need to edit this Pikachu and make him a bit smaller. No! What have I done? Oh, have they all gone massive? Fuck. There we go. I thought they were all going to be huge then. So it was good. Really enjoyed myself. Really, really enjoyed it. Yep, they're all massive. They're all massive. Hopefully they stay that size. I'll have to keep an eye on that. Holler in chat if a random rogue massive Pokemon just manages to work its way onto screen. Right, come on. Let's get this fucking Zubat down. Chat, why have I gone back into this fight and not bought any potions? That was a rookie mistake, wasn't it? Yeah, so Star Wars Week was good. We managed to do Dark Forces 2, Jedi Outcast, started Jedi Academy. So we need to finish Jedi Academy at some point on stream. We also started Galactic Battlegrounds last night, which is like the Age of Empires one, which we're going to put on a Sunday night after we finish the Age of Empires 2 DLC that we've recently got. So it's been good. I've really enjoyed it. We're not going to be revisiting Jedi Power Battles, I don't think. I might have to leave that for a while. Why are we dead? There's not even their Pokemon there. Did we just die of poison? I think we just died of poison. I'm not sure what happened there. Yeah, so now I enjoyed it. I hope everybody else who was watching it enjoyed it as well. It was good fun. It was good fun. We're going to lose more money again, aren't we, chat? Balls. it's getting the drop on us on every single attack here. Oh god, that's shocking. That's shockingly bad attack on our part. Oh, but he's got no energy. What am I doing? They're all going to die. It literally makes zero difference what we're doing right now because they're all going to get killed before we even get a chance to attack. It's just what's going on. It's just what's going on in this one. Yeah, we can use Boyd, but that doesn't do anything, does it? Just hurry up and kill me so we can move on, buy some potions, then come back and try this again. Oh man, we just lost another $288. Oh man. Libby Scurry to a Pokemon Center, protecting the exhausted and fainted Pokemon from further harm. Poor Pokemon. I don't like dying. Nope, we're good. Right, off to the Pokemon Center, Pokemon, even. Right, have we got like any money left after those just complete annihilations? Oh, we got $6,000. Okay. Buy four of them. No. Yep, buy. Are there any revives? No revives. Interesting. Well, we know we can get paralyzed, so 714, we can buy one of them. We'll buy two more of them. No, oh, it was antidotes that I wanted. Oh, I should have bought three of them. Oh my god. Did we get poison? Oh, fucking hell. What a plonker, chat. What a plonker. Right, and just so we don't. Like, we don't need to do this. But just so we get that extra hit in first. Where the fuck am I? Where am I going? Oop. Right. This is the one, chat. This is the one. Okay, come on, we don't need all this chit chat. Ugh. Straight off the bat with a toxic. Right, we'll do an absorb, then we'll do another razor leaf. Thank you. Not very effective, but that extra one little flip each time will help. Surprised they didn't heal up. Oh, you know what, chat? I always completely forget whenever we do Pokemon Days. We've got Who's That Pokemon, haven't we? Let me just check to see if this is working or not.
Who's That Pokemon?
Ooh, there you go, chat. Who's That Pokemon? Does that stay on screen the whole time? Oh. Nice, Jay. Nice. Now, does it stop or will it just come up with another one? Nidorino, it's never seen. It's just going to keep coming up with them. I spelled that wrong. What is it? Execute. Nope. Execute. Execute. Did I get it? Oh, Jay, you bastard. Execute. Didn't I spell it like that once? You bastard. I'm not sure if that does it, but we'll see if it pops up again. No, that did not work. Okay, it's just easier for the There we go, we'll make that the last one, because I can't remember how to stop it. Right, keep battling. There was a chance, you're on the ball with that one, Jay. You're on the ball.
Who's That Pokemon?
Why did that keep happening then? I disabled it. Should not have happened. Okay, hopefully that doesn't keep happening. That'll be distracting. Well, we're just gonna heal up. So, super potion, smash it. Yep, let's go. Well, thank you, Streamlabs, for pointing that out. If anybody hasn't already checked out the YouTube channel, there's a link on chat right now for you. Currently working my way through the Dark Souls bosses of Dark Souls 1 as a series on YouTube, so you get to watch my fails and successes on the various different bosses. Episode 10 went live last Thursday, and it is me against the Chaos Witch Quelaag, which is like a fiery, spidery, naked lady sort of a character. Good fight, it's a good fight. I enjoyed that one. I enjoyed most of them. That was a good one, though. And just as another reminder, guys, this Sunday, I would appreciate it if you guys could pencil in your diaries to come along to chat. We're going to be doing our first sponsored stream where I'm going to be doing a sponsored stream by Raid Shadow Legends. which is like an MMO game, and yeah, I'm going to be doing some details, putting them all on Discord. But yeah, the way you guys can help contribute is you can download the game and play through the tutorial and join the clan that I'm going to be creating on the weekend. We can all play together, have a bit of a laugh, and yeah, it should be good fun. It should be good fun, guys. So that will be around 12 midday on Sunday this week that I'm going to be doing that. So yeah, it'd be great if you could come along and join in with the Raid Shadow Legends Madness. Yeah, use code Libra fucking likes. I wish I could make up the code. But I can't. No, don't kill me. Oh, we did it! We fucking did it, chat. We did it. Hells to the yeah. 627 XP. Nice. Oh, holy shit. It took us halfway up the next level as well. Damn. This can't be. I lost you. Oh, shit. I must have clicked before I read it. You uppity something or other. Oops, I messed that one up. That's alright though, I quite enjoyed our battle. I guess it's time to say goodbye and leave for the time being. Team Galactic, they were saying they had to gather Pokemon and energy no matter what. It was for creating a new universe, or so they claimed. Nothing they said made any sort of sense to me. I can't tell you how grateful I am for saving me. I can finally see my little daughter again. Papa! Yuck, Papa, you're stinky. Go shower now, stinky. Oh, sorry, they have me working non-stop. Little girl, thank you, trainer. You made those bad people go away. I think the balloon Pokemon will come visiting again. The what Pokemon? Sorry, the what? Oh, yes, a balloon Pokemon appears in front of the Windworks. It's always a certain day of the week, but I'm not sure which day. Could its appearance have something to do with this Windworks using wind-generated energy? Does it wind? In front of the window? Right, we need to. We're poisoned. Run, little Pokemon. Nah, Growl dead. I mean, knocked out. Well, at least we did the Doobifurkin. We beat the commander of Thingamajigara. Okay, let's pop that in there. Heal up our Pokemon. Right. I am going to go ahead and call it a day for there, guys. We've made some little progress, a little bit of progress there on Pokemon Diamond today. Let's have a little look who we can send a raid over to, though. But yeah, just a reminder, I will be back tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. BST. And odds are we should be doing Dark Souls 3. I want to do it. I think we should do it. So that's probably what we're going to do, guys. We're going to be starting Dark Souls 3. In the meantime, though, we're going to send a little raid over to the main man, Mazer. He has recently dyed his beard blue. And yeah, it looks pretty blue. Looks pretty blue, chat. Yeah, Mazer. So, we'll go over there, send some love, and enjoy the blue beardness for him. But guys, thank you so much for the support. I really, really appreciate it. Hope you've enjoyed a bit of Pokemon Diamond tonight. I'll be back tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. There, at the moment, there won't be a stream Wednesday daytime. Hopefully that'll change if I can get some childcare sorted. There will be a stream Wednesday night for Warzone, definitely a stream Thursday for more Dark Souls 3, no stream Friday, but I'll do a stream Friday night, then we'll have Saturday night stream where we'll definitely do Resident Evil 2 Remake, and then Sunday will be the big sponsored stream. So guys, thank you so, so much for coming and hanging out and for all the support as always. Have a fantastic rest of your day, whatever you choose to do, and I will see you all again very, very soon. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.